Let's take a look at the advanced functions inside the sampler. There's some pretty neat stuff it can do here. So we've already learned about the bank and the button. But what happens on the button? Well, what you can do is you can have the button play in a certain order, like repeat. So we've gone through that. We had that first sample of me just like this, just like this. And it just plays over and over again, but I can actually make it play and stop. So when I push the button the first time it plays, I push the button a second time and it stops. I can do it so it fades. I can have it stop on release or fade on release. And I can even make it loop. Now that the looping one is probably the easiest one to show, because we know we had that Peter Griffin flip them off thing. So we're gonna go like this and we're gonna turn it to loop and we're gonna do this.
Flip them off, flip them off, flip them off, flip them off, flip them off.
Okay, so you can get a bunch of things rolling like that, which is pretty fun. But the other ones need a little bit longer of an example here. So I've created a really bad long sample here. I'm gonna set it to play stop. Now this one is just me. I've made a very long sample so that we can use the sample that is very long, that is too long, that I am talking about to show you some of the functions. Okay, so that was me talking for too long, but you notice I had it set to play stop, and as soon as I push the button again, it stopped. The next one is play fade. It's pretty obvious. Here we go. Bad sample again. I've made a very long sample so that we can use the sample that is very long, that is too long, that I am talking about. And you see how it faded out there. Really great for music. If you have an intro bumper for like a podcast or a section of your show that you want to do, and you're not entirely sure how long you're going to talk over it, and then eventually you're like, okay, I'm done, I better fade out. You just hit that button and it starts to fade out right then. You've also got stop on release, which is kind of like a momentary playback. So you put it like this. Now, as long as I'm holding the button, it's going to play. I've made a very long sample. But as soon as I let it go, use the sample that is very... it stops. Similarly, fade on release, same idea. I've made a very long sample so that we can use the sample that is very long, that is too long. And then it fades out. So now here is the next really cool thing about the sampler. You can make stacks. And what that means is I've got this sample here. So it's my recording that I made. Okay. And I have this one of the Peter Griffin one. I'm going to take this Peter one. And I'm going to drag it to the same place where this other sample exists. Now there are two samples assigned to this one button. See this recording and that recording. So now I have the first one. If I go play next, it's this on this bottom button here, right? Bottom right, play next, sequential. It'll play me.
Well, you forgot to flip them off, but other than that, nice job.
So start with Peter. I've made a very long sample. Goes to that one.
Well,
goes back to Peter.
Off.
I've made a very long sample. Goes back to me.
Well, you forgot to flip them off, but other than that, nice job.
Okay, so now you've got multiple samples that play in a sequential order. So if you had five of them, it would play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can also choose random. So it will pick at random out of this sample stack, anything from there, it'll just randomly pick one and play it. So why do you want it? What's the advantage? The advantage is, imagine you have 6 or 8 cool things that you wanna use as like a post-kill taunt for somebody. You know, you're playing a game and you just wanna like yell something at them when you kill them. You can use a stacked sample in random mode. So instead of having 4 kill shot, you know, or taunts afterwards, you can use one button and stack 4 on that same button. And now that you have a single button that is your taunt button, you hit that and randomly stuff comes out. So you can get a bit of an unknown quality to it where you're getting random things that are happening. You can play off that with your stream. And also you can have these more thematic buttons. You could have in a tabletop game, you could have a whole bunch of combat sounds. You don't know exactly which one's going to come up, but in the moment, it doesn't really matter. You just need a combat sound. So you push that button. It can kind of help you keep control over the number of samples that you have and make them a little bit more manageable from playback to playback. Another cool thing that the sampler can do is you can use the routing tab to determine what is actually going into the sampler. So you can see here that the only thing going in by default is my mic. So it means I can make a sample really quickly on the fly. But what if I wanted to sample somebody from my Discord chat because they're hilarious and I want to get, you know, their voice on my stream or something like that? I could turn off sampler in the routing tab and turn on chat in. And that's going to be sampling anything I hear from Discord. So what I could do is say, you know, say something funny, just say 3, 2, 1, and then whatever you're going to say. As soon as you hear them saying 3, 2, 1, you hold down the button, you record everything they're saying, you then go into the sampler and you're going to have the waveform there, and you just trim out the 3-2-1, and now you have a sample of your friend saying something funny that you can use again. It works exactly the same for music. If you've got Spotify running and you want to capture a little bit of a song, or your game is playing, as long as the game is assigned to the game fader, it will pick it up there. Otherwise, you can use system as kind of a catch-all. Works the same for console and line-in as well. Obviously, at the end here, you can't sample a sample because that would just create feedback. And that about covers it for the sampling. There's a lot of flexibility in there to play with.